If the house doesn't sell soon, and the bills keep coming in, I don't know what I'm going to do.
Can I help, Mommy?
No, sweetheart. I sure wish Daddy were here.
Maybe Daddy's Air Force can help.
Maybe they can.
Dear Mrs. Long, we're reviewing your application and we'll let you know the results as soon as possible.
Hello?
Hello, Mrs. Long. This is Mr. Vogel from the Air Force Assistance Fund.
Yes?
I've got good news. Your application was approved for the entire amount.
Oh, thank you. I don't know what we would have done without your help.
See, Mommy, I told you they could help.
You were right, sweetheart. You were really right.
Giving a helping hand, caring enough to help someone who needs help. That's what the Air Force Assistance Fund is all about. It's a way that we in the Air Force give a hand to members of our Air Force family in need, active and retired, guard and reserve. Help can come in the form of financial assistance to a young airman who needs to fly home on emergency leave. It might come as an interest-free loan to clear financial difficulties. Or it might be a college or vocational education loan to a military dependent. The Air Force Aid Society helps in all these ways. Our retired members are also part of the Air Force family. The Air Force Assistance Fund helps support the enlisted men's widows and dependents home and the Air Force Village, where comfortable and secure housing is provided to retired members and their dependents, regardless of their ability to pay. The Enlisted Men's Widows and Dependents Home and Air Force Village, as well as the Air Force Aid Society, are supported by your contributions to the Air Force Assistance Fund. Your support helps the Air Force family take care of its own. Please, give a helping hand. The Wright brothers design a machine that will become the world's first airplane. Later, the airplane comes of age. Designers dream of faster, more maneuverable flying machines. In 1941, America enters the Second World War. The designs that will win the war are rushed from the drawing board into combat. Before it's over, the first jet planes streak across the skies. A new era begins. Man flies in space. The pace of change continues to accelerate. Radical new technologies find their way into designs for the future. Is flying a new generation of aircraft. Aircraft with capabilities only dreamt of 20 years ago. Space-age technologies like the fly-by-wire control system in this F-16 were found only in spacecraft back then.
We've come a long way in the last 20 years.
The next 20 years will be even more exciting, with dramatic new developments in aerospace science and technology. What will the Air Force be like as it approaches the 21st century? Well, join me as we try to answer this question by looking at the drawing boards of your Air Force now. Exciting to think about what the Air Force will be like in 20 years, but in some respects, tomorrow's Air Force is already here. This is HIMAT, short for Highly Maneuverable Aircraft Technology. It's a joint Air Force-NASA program to test future flight concepts. It's a miniature wing computer, able to outfly any fighter plane in the air today. A typical mission starts at 45,000 feet as HIMAT drops from the wing of a B-52. Its pilot is 9 miles below in an air-conditioned building, flying HIMAT by remote control. Other manned airplanes are demonstrating new ways to fly. Tomorrow's aircraft will be the product of many new skills, whole new technologies that will push today's science to the limits of possibility. Upturned wingtips, called winglets, improve stability and reduce drag. These small wings, or canards, help the plane make tighter turns, improve airflow over the wings. The wings themselves may even change shape during the flight to optimize performance. New materials will be used to build the next generation of aircraft. Almost all of HIMAT's skin is made of graphite epoxy, a composite material twice as strong as aluminum at half the weight. Metal rivets will be replaced by, what else? Airplane glue, actually an epoxy bonding compound. All of this adds up to a stronger, lighter, more fuel-efficient airplane, one whose new engine design will enable it to fly further, faster, and higher, and at less cost. Other technologies will play a major role in tomorrow's aircraft. Digital control systems linked by fiber optics will make planes more responsive and easier to maintain. These replaceable electronic modules are making it happen. What will these 21st century aircraft look like? Some of them may be difficult to see, on radar at least. It's called stealth technology, a combination of design, materials, and components that will help future bombers and fighters penetrate enemy airspace without being detected. But whether or not we can see them on radar, tomorrow's aircraft will be exciting, both to look at and to fly. Complex, so does the job of flying them. Early aviators had to literally fly by the seat of their pants. This World War I biplane has about 10 switches and gauges in its open cockpit. By World War II, the pilot's job had become more complicated as instrument panels grew. This P-51 Mustang has some 35 controls and instruments. Today's F-15 Eagle has more than 300 and thick checklists on how to use them. The modern instrument panel is almost too much for one man to handle. Tomorrow's cockpit will be simpler, more efficient. Checklists and switches will be replaced by computers. Push a couple of buttons and a tough job like aligning an inertial navigation unit will happen automatically, and the computer will tell you when it's finished. Dozens of instruments and gauges will be electronically represented on television displays. Only essential flight information will be continually displayed, but other data, including checklists, may be called up at the touch of a button. Even older airplanes will be retrofitted with electronic displays and computers in tomorrow's Air Force.
Awkward flight maps will be replaced by a computerized electronic map. It will show not only position, but also altitude, and even a perspective view of the terrain ahead. Night and bad weather operations will be simplified by infrared sensors. A special head-up display will show the pilot what's ahead, allowing him to fly virtually blind at low level.
In the cockpit of the future, information will be displayed in pictures. It's called a pictorial format program. Its purpose? To reduce the time needed for a pilot to interpret data.
Computer-generated graphics will show what's happening at a glance. One picture will indeed be worth a thousand words. And critical time saved in high-stress situations. Other pictures will show the pilot where he's going and what's ahead that may pose a threat. Surface-to-air missiles or enemy fighters. This could prevent unpleasant surprises.
Man and machine will be integrated as never before. Man's judgment and the machine's abilities will make a formidable team. Pilot and plane will talk together, work together, search the skies together, and fight together. Displays projected on the helmet visor will show the pilot vital information and enable him to aim weapons just by looking at targets. A future air battle may look something like this. Eventually, the pilot may see a computer-synthesized version of his entire world on his helmet visor. Incredible machines. But what about man? Who'll fly these sophisticated aircraft?
Tomorrow's Air Force pilots are the sons and daughters of today's airmen. Their training has already begun, at 25 cents a lesson. The generation that will fly the Air Force into the 21st century is no stranger to the kind of video simulation to be found in future aircraft. And the Air Force will continue this training in sophisticated simulators. Cockpits that fly without ever leaving the ground. Simulation saves time, fuel, and lives in training tomorrow's pilots. But it'll never replace the real thing.
Chappy,
Chappy, Chappy,
get five.
That's a kill. Good shot.
While pilots dogfight in the skies overhead, computer-generated images mimic and record their maneuvers on the ground. The air battle can be analyzed from several angles and played back for the pilots when they return. This is one battle they can fight more than once, learning from their mistakes and emerging as winners. And in the process, wringing the most value out of every dollar spent to keep them in the air.
I got a beautiful box to it.
Aerial warfare is complicated now, but it's going to get even more complicated during the next 20 years. Roger's ray gun may be reality in tomorrow's Air Force.
tower.
Oh, there's the rumble in our building. It looks good. It looks like a good flight. It's a beautiful takeoff so far. Camera platform is shaking. But what a beautiful flight.
The space shuttle marks a turning point for the Air Force. In the coming years, it will become an aerospace force with sustained operations in orbit and beyond.
Columbia, we're looking at a great picture from, looks like, Camera Delta.
Hey, very good.
Air Force people will fly in space, work in space, live in space.
Okay, we see Fan A on, and we'd like you to take Bravo on.
The Air Force will continue launching satellites with a small fleet of space shuttles. Satellites for communication, weather, early warning, and reconnaissance. By the 21st century, the Air Force may even man a space operations center, an orbiting platform dedicated to defense operations. An advanced shuttle is already under study by the Air Force. A smaller delta-wing vehicle, it would take off like an airplane, fly into orbit, and return like a glider. The dawn of the 21st century, we'll see a new Air Force, an Air Force shaped by advances in aerospace science and technology. Its ultimate form we can only guess at, but it will be exciting and it will be challenging. The 21st century is not far away, but it's more than technology and hardware, more than cold steel and printed circuits. Its vital component is still people.